we want to write the system of equations as an augmented matrix and then solve the system by writing the matrix in reduced row echelon form. So because we have a system of three linear equations with three unknowns, we'll have a 3x4 augmented matrix. And since the equations are already in standard form, looking at the first equation, the first row of our matrix will be 1, 2, negative 1, negative 10. The second row will be 2, negative 3, 2, 2. The third row will be 1, 1, 3, and 0. Notice the first three columns represent the x, y, and z coefficients, and the fourth column represents the constants. Now let's review reduced row echelon form of an augmented matrix. Number one, the first non-zero element in each row called the leading entry must be 1. Number two, each leading entry or 1 in a column is to the right of the leading entry or 1 in the previous row. Number three, rows with all zero elements, if any, are below rows having a non-zero element. If these first three conditions are met, we have row echelon form. This fourth condition is what makes reduced row echelon form. In each column that contains a leading entry or 1, all other elements of the column are 0. So because we have a 3x4 augmented matrix, reduced row echelon form will fit one of these forms below, where notice if the main diagonal only contains 1, we have one solution. If the main diagonal contains a 0, we have either no solution in this case here, or infinite solutions in this case here if we have a row of zeros. We'll transform the matrix into this form using Gaussian elimination, which allows any two rows to be interchanged. The elements of any row can be multiplied by a non-zero real number, and any row can be changed by adding or subtracting the corresponding elements with another row. So this can be a fairly involved process, so let's start by focusing on obtaining a 0 in row 2, column 1, and row 3, column 1. So if we focus on just row 1 and row 2, if we replace row 2 with negative 2 times row 1 plus row 2, that would give us a 0 in this position here. And now if we look at row 3 and focus on row 2, notice if we replace row 3 with negative 2 times row 3, that would give us a negative 2 here. And if we add this to row 2, we would get a 0. Let's start by performing these two row operations. So we'll leave the first row the same for right now. And now for row 2, we'll have negative 2 times 1 plus 2, that's 0. Negative 2 times 2 plus negative 3, that's negative 7. Negative 2 times negative 1 plus 2 is 4. Negative 2 times negative 10 plus 2 would be 22. And now for row 3, we have negative 2 times row 3 plus row 2. So negative 2 times 1 plus 2 is 0. Negative 2 times 1 plus negative 3 is negative 5. Negative 2 times 3 plus 2 is negative 4. And negative 2 times 0 plus 2 is 2. Now let's focus on obtaining a 0 in this position and this position. Well, looking at row 2 and row 3, notice how the elements in column 3 are already opposites, which means if we replace row 2 with row 2 plus row 3, we would obtain a 0 in column 3, and we also would not lose the 0 in column 1. Now to obtain a 0 where we have negative 5, we have to use row 2 so we don't lose the 0 in column 1. And since the least common multiple of 5 and 7 is 35, we can obtain a 0 in this position if we replace row 3 with negative 5 times row 2 plus 7 times row 3. So again, the first row is going to stay the same for right now. And now for row 2, we'll have row 2 plus row 3. So we have 0. Negative 7 plus negative 5 is negative 12. 4 plus negative 4 is 0. 22 plus 2 is 24. And now for row 3, we'll have negative 5 times row 2 plus 7 times row 3. So we have negative 5 times 0 plus 7 times 0, it's still 0. And then we have negative 5 times negative 7, that's 35, plus 7 times negative 5, or plus negative 35, that's 0. And then we have negative 5 times 4, that's negative 20, plus 7 times negative 4, that's negative 28, so we have negative 48. And then we have negative 5 times 22, that's negative 110, plus 7 times 2, or plus 14, that's negative 96. Now if we take a look at row 1, let's obtain a 0 in this position here. Let's go ahead and use row 2. The least common multiple of 2 and 12 is 12. So let's replace row 1 with 6 times row 1 plus row 2. We also want the first element in each row to be positive 1. So looking at row 2, let's make this negative 12 positive 1 by multiplying row 2 by negative 1/12. And to make this negative 48 positive 1, let's replace row 3 with negative 1 over 48 times row 3. So let's be careful here. We have 6 times row 1 plus row 2. 6 times 1 plus 0 is 6. 6 times 2 plus negative 12 is 0. 6 times negative 1 plus 0 is negative 6.
6 times negative 10 is negative 60, plus 24 is negative 36.
And now multiplying by negative 1/12 is the same as dividing by negative 12. So we would have 0, 1, 0, negative 2. For row 3, we would have 0, 0, 1, and positive 2. Now we're almost in reduced row echelon form. We need this element to be 0. So let's go ahead and replace this with 6 times row 3 plus row 1. So the second and third rows will stay the same. So for row 1, we'll have 6 times 0 plus 6, that's still 6. 6 times 0 plus 0 is still 0. And 6 times 1 is 6 plus negative 6, that's 0. And we have 6 times 2, that's 12.
Plus negative 36.
That's negative 24. And now for the last step, we need this 6 to be a positive 1, so we're going to replace row 1 with 1/6 times row 1. So we'll have 1, 0, 0, negative 4, 0, 1, 0, negative 2, and 0, 0, 1, 2. Now our matrix is in reduced row echelon form, so if we write this back as a system of equations, we'll have our solution. Remember, these columns represent the coefficients of x, y, and z. So row 1 is telling us that x is equal to negative 4. The second row is telling us y is equal to negative 2. And the third row is telling us that z is equal to positive 2. If we want, we can write this as an ordered triple, negative 4, comma, negative 2, comma, 2. Either way, our system has one solution, which means the system is consistent and independent. If we were to graph these in space, each of these equations represents a plane, so these planes should intersect in a single point with these coordinates. Let's go ahead and verify that. Here's the graph of the three planes. Notice how these planes do intersect in one point, this point here, which would have the coordinates negative 4, negative 2, 2. Okay, I hope you found this explanation helpful.